This is NDTV. And you're watching NDTV Hindu.
First they stopped the DMK and now they don't know where to turn. Ramadosa's PMK is now crying out with an SOS. Opposition parties go ballistic on the price rise issue, announce massive protests on the 8th of this month. Will young Divya, who committed suicide because of her lecturer's insensitivity, get justice? The court dismisses lecturer's bail appeal. NDTV Hindu's investigation in Cuddalore reveals more skeletons in the school's closets. Students say that they're beaten up for silly reasons. College students lock up professors in classrooms after professors failed nearly a whole batch. A fallout of the Anetra suicide case. After Amarnath, the BJP bats for fishermen, Sushma Swaraj visits the grieving families in Nagapattinam.
Casual attitude of the Indian government is responsible for the killings of our fishermen of Tamil Nadu.
Sources reveal that the Central Crime Branch is eyeing the BCCI in the IPL case. We have exclusive information. A very good evening and welcome to News Tonight with me, Ashmit. Let's have a look at stories coming in from across the nation. Telecom Minister Sibal puts the 2G blame on the NDA government, says that the lapses in telecom policy began in 2003. Former TRAI chairman Pradeep Baijal is likely to be arrested now, CBI sources tell NDTV. Today is the deadline set for Mubarak's exit. The cries for his removal gain momentum in Cairo. The BJP attacks the Prime Minister for the leak of the SIT report. Demand a probe. Dada could miss out on the IPL action as IPL Governing Council crushes Kochi's last bid to sign up the Southpaw. Well, first up, for how long can a cat sit on the fence? At some point, it would have to lean either on the right or the left. But the fence sitter in Tamil Nadu politics, the PMK, it seems, cannot do both. Having hurt the DMK chief's ego and also closing options with the AIADMK, will the PMK now continue to keep sitting on the fence, not knowing which way to go? Now, sources say that Anbumani Ramadas is now hoping that his rapport with the Congress president Sonia Gandhi works during his SOS situation.
A foot in mouth leads to no alliance in hand, at least in Tamil Nadu politics. S. Ramadas, the founder of the PMK, is now apparently very insecure. Having hurt the DMK chief's ego, the PMK has only made it difficult to get into an alliance with the DMK-Congress combine. An alliance with the AIADMK is unlikely, with Vijayakant and his DMDK team inching closer. On Sunday, the DMK chief in New Delhi called the PMK its ally ahead of the assembly polls. An overconfident PMK neither confirmed nor denied the alliance with its friend turned foe. The 86-year-old chief minister ensured he gave a fitting reply.
Sadarpam Soodalahel, Avargal Sarvil, Purupire Ullavahel, Engelam Gullathurahel, Ivartheveithu, Pama Kavam, Thivuka Kutadil, Edamberakulam, Edmade.
Sources say Anbumani Ramadas is planning an SOS meeting with Sonia Gandhi. But convincing her won't be an easy task given their recent estrangement in 2009 when the party joined the AIADMK for an alliance for the Lok Sabha polls. The PMK's share of votes is a little more than 5%. The Patali Makkal Katchi is now desperate to shake hands with the Congress party. The party is a splits villa, with some think tanks within completely against a few decisions taken by the party in the past which have completely gone wrong. Apparently, its vote share is inversely proportional to its confidence or perhaps complacence, which has only reduced its bargaining power. Even before the ego issue broke out, the DMK, the ruling party, apparently did not offer more than 18 seats to a PMK, which was asking for about 50 seats. In Chennai, Radhika Iyer, NDTV.
For some more political news, AIADMK General Secretary Jayalalitha, MDMK Chief Vaiko, CPM State Secretary G. Ramakrishnan, CPI State Head D. Pandian and other allies today announced that the joint agitation against the fuel price hikes and the 2G scam. The protests are slated for the 8th of this month. Now, the leaders cried out that the fuel prices have been hiked 7 times in the last 6 months. Raking up the 2G issue, the scam allegations also featured prominently in their criticisms. And the AIADMK Chief Jayalalitha announced fresh protests at Chayyar in Thiruvannamalai on Sunday to fuel the demand for a JPC probe into the 2G scam. She alleged that the first family of Tamil Nadu was directly involved, citing the Neera Radia tapes. She argued that such connections would come out only if a JPC probe is conducted. She said that the UPA government cannot ignore the demands for a JPC any longer. Well, not to be outdone in this ongoing slugfest in the political theatre, the Congress unleashed its own gladiator, Kapil Sibal. While commenting on the findings of the one-man Justice Patil Commission, the new telecom minister alleged that the roots of the scam can be traced back to the NDA regime. Now, citing the report, Sibal pointed out that all the decisions on a spectrum from 2003 were non-transparent. Now, Sibal said that the NDA will have to answer these critical questions.
शुरुआत तो उन्होंने की कि जो मंत्रीगण उस कैबिनेट में बैठे थे, उन्होंने कैसे इसको अलाउ किया? ये बड़े गंभीर सवाल उठते हैं और शायद आने वाले दिनों में जो लोग आज आरोप लगा रहे हैं उनको जवाब देना पड़ेगा.
Well, even as the Spectrum Roger is firmly within the grasp of the CBI, the investigating agencies are gaining momentum as they scout for targets. Now, next on the radar, according to sources, is the former TRAI chairman Pradeep Bejal, who served during the period from 2003 to 2006. Well, coming back to the state and moving on to the suicide case of young BCom student Divya, the bail petition of 4 lecturers of MGR Janki Women's College was dismissed by the Principal Sessions Court just a while back. Now, the 4 lecturers have now been taken to the Pural prison and will be lodged there till further hearing. Now, let me remind our viewers that these 4 lecturers were arrested following Divya's suicide. Divya had allegedly killed herself because she was stripped during an inspection when one of her classmates had lost some money. And these lecturers, in fact, had fell ill conveniently yesterday, just when they were about to be arrested in the abetment of suicide case. Now, will this young girl get justice? Will her grieving family get some reprieve? And are these teachers actually responsible for the suicides? These, of course, are the big questions coming out at this point. Well, on to the case of the 12-year-old Alwyn's death. This boy's death has sent a shocker across the district, having taken corporal punishment to the next level. Now, with the post-mortem report still awaited, NDTV Hindu, in its visit to Alwyn's school, found out that there are several other cases of students being beaten up that are not brought to the notice. Our reporter Krishnamurthy brings us this shocking report from the Cuddalore district.
எங்களுக்கு ஒரு போன் கூட பண்ணலங்க அவங்க எதுவுமே சொல்லல செத்து தூக்கிட்டு வந்து ஆஸ்பத்திரியில வச்சுட்டு எங்களுக்கு போன் பண்றாங்க நேரம் ஹாஸ்பிட்டலுக்கு வந்து பார்த்தா எப்படி செத்து கிடக்குது.
An inconsolable mother who lost her 12-year-old son Alwyn studying at the St. Joseph's School in Cuddalore. Alwyn was reportedly harassed by the school warden at this very hostel. The FIR registered against the school principal and warden says Alwyn died due to an unnatural cause.
Based on the complaint, we filed an FIR under section 174 CRPC, body the internal parts. They are reserving it for analysis at the forensic lab at Chennai. After getting the forensic lab report only, they can give a final opinion as to the cause of death.
Meanwhile, accusations that corporal punishment is common is made by many residents.
ரொம்ப மோசமான ட்ரீட்மெண்ட் வந்து மாணவர்கள் வந்து கொடுக்குறது ஒரு சைக்கலாஜிக்கலாக வந்து மாணவர்கள் வந்து மனோரீதியாக வந்து பாதிக்கப்பட்டுட்டு இருக்காங்க.
தக்க நடவடிக்கை எடுக்கணும், இல்லைனா ஸ்ட்ரைக் மாரி சாலை மறியல் நடக்கும் அப்படின்னு மாணவர் சங்கத்தில் சொல்கிறோம்.
Of course, the school has strongly disputed that Alwyn was physically punished.
அவனை எந்த சூழலையும் யாரும் அடித்ததாகவோ அடிச்சனால இந்த மாதிரி ஜோரம் வந்ததாகவோ எந்த ஒரு கண்டிஷனும் இல்லை, அடிக்கவும் இல்லை. ஏன்னா எங்கள் இன்ஸ்டியூஷனில் வந்து பசங்க 6-8 பசங்க அடிக்கணும்னு அவசியமும் கிடையாது. இறண்டான்னு எங்களுக்கு செய்தி கிடச்சி இதுக்கப்புறம் தான் நாங்கள் என்ன பண்ணோம், பாய்ஸ் அந்த திரும்ப அந்த பாய்ஸை கூப்பிட்டு விசாரிச்சு. ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் அவங்க என்ன பாய் ஏன் திடீர்னு இருந்தால் என்னென்னு தெரியும், எங்களுக்கு கஷ்டமாக மனசு கஷ்டமாக போய் மன இறக்கப்பட்டு அந்த பசங்க கூப்பிட்டு விசாரிச்சப்போ தான் தெரியுது இவனுக்கு 2 மாதமாக உடம்பு சரியில்லாமல் இருந்திருக்கு, ஹார்ட்டில் ஓடினா ரொம்ப மயக்கம் வரும், ஹார்ட் அடைக்கிற மாதிரி இருக்கும், அதனால் ஓடவே மாட்டான் அப்படிங்கிறத விஷயத்த பசங்க அவனுடைய ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸு சொன்னாங்க.
This revelation by the school has raised several important questions. How come the school never figured out the critical condition of the boy for 2 whole months and came to know about it only after his death? Also, Alvin's parents claimed that they never heard of any such condition from the boy himself, even though they were in regular touch and the boy kept updating about the warden's harassment.
Meanwhile, students say they are beaten or punished for the silliest of reasons.
ஒரு தடவை வந்து கேட்ஃபன் சார் வந்து புக் ஏற்றுவார்லன்னு சொல்லிட்டு வார்டன் ரூமில் அனுப்பிவிட்ருக்காங்க சார். முட்டி போட வச்சுக்கிறாங்க சார். அப்போ வந்து அவங்க அடிச்சிருக்காங்க சார். பேசினா மட்டும் அடிப்பாங்க சார். வேறு ஏதாவது தப்பு பண்ண அடிப்பாங்க சார். அவ்வளோதான் சார்.
கார்பரல் பனிஷ்மெண்ட் ஹஸ் பீன் டினவுன்ஸ்ட் பை சக்சஸிவ் ஸ்டேட் கவர்மெண்ட்ஸ். ஸ்கூல் எஜுகேஷன் மினிஸ்டர் தங்கம் தென்னரசு டூ ஹஸ் பீன் அ வோக்கல் கிரிட்டிக் ஆஃப் சச் ப்ராக்டிசஸ். அண்ட் யெட் பனிஷ்மெண்ட் சீம்ஸ் டு ஸ்டாக் ஆர் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ் இன் ஸ்கூல்ஸ். அண்ட் வாட் இஸ் வரியிங் சீம்ஸ் டு கோ அன்செக்ட். The investigation into Alvin's death will be key to educating the teachers. With Lalit Jude and Krishnamurthy in Cuddalore, this is Ragamalika for NDTV Hindu.
Well, in a similar case, the principal of Lamartnia School for Boys and 3 other teachers were given bail by Kolkata High Court. Now, the court will frame charges against them on the 17th of February. All of them have been so far been charged with causing grievous injuries to the 13-year-old boy who committed suicide on the 12th of February last year. Well, in a fallout of the Anetha suicide case, professors failed students who protested. Students in turn lock up their professors in the college. We get you more details on the other side.